This collection was incredibly powerful.
It's not just a regular fashion show, that was really a performance as well.
It's like an expression of strength and togetherness and feminism.
This was theater, this was poetry, this was a statement.
Hi, this is Rick Owens and this is my show. You know, when I first started, I always resented the idea of extravagant, spectacular parade float outfits only being confined to the runway. There was that picture that Annie Leibovitz took of Lee Bowery that had always intrigued me. It was very sweet, it was tender, kind of creepy, and very elegant.
My name's Danielle Levitt. I'm a photographer. I've been working with Rick Owens since 2012. He had been doing a lot of theatrical presentations. He did the black metal group that were hung upside down and playing music. We did the step show together. He did the pantless men. There was a real sense of theatrics that he was processing right at that point.
I am Nicole Phelps, the global director of Vogue Runway. There's a real sense of anticipation I remember feeling at the show. Those first few looks were, you know, as normal as a Rick Owens show gets.
I wanted some strict, severe looks at the beginning that showed a freedom of flesh.
And then look four came out, and it's this woman who has another woman strapped to her back. And from there, it got only more weird.
Women holding women was such a tender idea.
They were looking for people pretty specific, like performer and dancers, tall girls, strong girls. So actually, me and Allison, we were helping out with just like what is possible to do with the body and how are you comfortable in the harnesses? I mean, Allison was great as well because she's an actual acrobat.
I was attached like a backpack. The straps on Hilva were attached on her back and around her hips. Being upside down for a long period of time, that's hard for the blood flow. After a while, you feel like dizzy a little bit. So during the runway, I had to make sure that my neck wasn't too tight. My legs and arm were not too melted for good looking, but also for Ilva to have like the easiest experience possible holding me.
I talked about the Lee Bowery reference earlier, and we started from there, and you know, we experimented. Where can we go from that? What other configurations can we make? There were references to birthing, references to aging, the cycle of life. Then, you know, I stuck a couple of high heels on the girls being carried just because it was funny. I remember there was one review and it said something about how it was difficult seeing the strain on the women's faces who were being held upside down. But these were athletes. I didn't, you know, make our model community do this. And that strain is part of the burden of caring people and being a part of a community. So I think I'm very satisfied with that element of strain.
This land is mine.
I chose the song This Land, which was a theme song from the movie Exodus, and asked James Lavelle from Uncle to do a modern arrangement of it.
It was really about the performance. It was about doing a track for a performance, but wanting to do something more contemporary, more stripped back. It's a song about being one with the land.
It was about the pride of your place in the world. It's a beautiful, elegant song with like a little tiny hint of hysteria underneath it.
I've been very lucky. I've worked with some of the greatest singers in the world, and Eska's up there. The power she has and the control she has on her voice is extraordinary.
There was a really clear brief given to me by James Lavelle, and Rick Owens had chosen the song. He was incredibly clear about its function in his show and also how he perceived my role in the live performance, the staging, my presentation. It was all about the words. It was all about the epic, very slow tempo.
You know, for a Rick Owens show, this was really a no makeup, makeup look. It jibes with his message that women are strong, flat out. There's no artifice.
The hair was by Duffy, who I've been working with for a while now.
Hi guys, I'm Duffy. As a hairdresser, for me, everything is about a silhouette. I think what I found so incredible about this was exactly that. It was the silhouette and the shape that was created by two bodies that were essentially one. I think look 37 was my favorite. The girls worked together so perfectly. You've got the girl in the front with a very strict, small head. You've got the girl at the back with this big sort of mop of this dandelion, was almost sort of burnt orange red hair that was floating and bouncing as they walked.
As quote unquote normal as this is of a collection for Rick, there's still incredible amounts of experimentation.
Things extending from the body had become probably one of my main motifs. At the very beginning, my very first collections had these viscose skirts that dragged on the ground. And that was my first message saying that you can wear runway during the day. You can live that kind of dream life.
For me, he's managed to articulate through clothing a woman's strength.
I might have gotten a little bit misty at the finale with Eska singing. She has some kind of long note at the end that was very effective.
This is the kind of show that people would be clamoring to see Rick afterwards with so many questions. What does it all mean? It felt like a tribute to women's strength. And as a woman, it was hard not to walk away and feel empowered and full of optimism and joy. And I would say in general, that's how I tend to feel whenever I leave a Rick Owens show.
Being at Rick's shows when he creates moments like these, you know you're part of history. It's incredible. He creates a collection that we can speak about 7 years later, 10 years later, 20 years later. He creates a collection that stays within our psyche and our mindset of like the greatest shows that have been put on.
Going to court is a fashion show. Going to church is a fashion show. This is a great example of being able to integrate behavior into a whole story about beauty. Beautiful clothes, beautiful grooming, beautiful gestures, beautiful instincts. I know going in that there's gonna be some provocation, and that's what I'm in it for. A little shock value is what we need every once in a while. I don't mind something a little bit disquieting in a collection. Life is disquieting.